You did it! Using CRISPR, you have successfully genetically modified your cells and can finally move on to the next phase of your project. But wait, how can you be sure it worked? Could it be possible your CRISPR knockout is actually a mixed population of edited and non-edited cells? Let's take a closer look. CRISPR knockout is typically achieved by the introduction of insertions or deletions, otherwise known as indels, within the desired gene. As most mammalian cells are diploids, a complete gene knockout occurs when both gene alleles carry an indel. In other words, you're looking for a biallelic knockout. Finding this clone will require some detective work. Following your CRISPR experiment, some clones will have indels on only one allele, otherwise known as monoallelic, while others will have indels on both alleles, otherwise known as either homozygous or heterozygous biallelic, depending on the edit type. Having identical edits on both alleles are known as homozygous biallelic editing. If the edits are different, then it is known as heterozygous biallelic editing. And others will have no indels at all. This would be wild type, unedited. How to determine what types of edits your cells have? Picture this. Your deadline is coming up and you need results fast. You're on a tight budget and the clock is ticking. You need a way to quickly and efficiently screen for biallelic knockout clones. Let's explore our options. There are three potential strategies to screen for your CRISPR knockout clones. First, Sanger sequencing each clone. Second, perform the mismatch cleavage assay with the T7E1 enzyme. Or three, conduct an in vitro Cas9 cleavage assay. First, let's look into Sanger sequencing. This involves analyzing each clone to identify monoallelic, biallelic, and wild-type genotypes by directly unveiling their genetic code. But there's a problem, time. You have hundreds of clones which need to be screened, and this can be both time-consuming and labor-intensive. Even if you stayed up all night preparing these hundreds of samples, which still need to be shipped out and sequenced if you don't have a sequencing machine. After that, you still have to wait several days for the results, and then align and analyze each sequence one by one to determine what type of edits your clones have. There must be a faster way. Let's take a look at the mismatch cleavage assay. This assay is commonly used for CRISPR knockout and indel detection due to its simplicity and fast turnaround time. Following CRISPR knockout of your gene of interest, DNA is extracted from the cells and your gene of interest is PCR amplified. During the assay, high temperature is used to denature double-stranded DNA into single-stranded DNA, which is then followed by low temperature. In this process, edited single-stranded DNA will anneal to unedited single-stranded DNA, thus creating duplexed base pair mismatches. The T7E1 enzyme is then used to specifically detect these mismatched DNAs, which results in a double-stranded break. Analyzing the results on agarose gel will reliably show you which clones have undergone editing. But what kinds of edits exactly? When using CRISPR to genetically edit your cells, there are four possible genotype outcomes. 1. No editing occurs. This would be a wild-type clone. 2. A single editing event occurs only to one allele of the gene. This is called a heterozygous monoallelic clone. 3. Two different editing events occur to each allele, otherwise known as heterozygous biallelic clone. 4. The same mutation occurs to both alleles. This results in a homozygous biallelic clone. Of these four outcomes, the biallelics are the only two desired genotypes, ensuring there is no wild-type allele remaining. This is where the mismatch cleavage assay falls short. The assay relies on mismatched base pairs to detect gene editing. This means that the T7E1 enzyme cleaves the DNA when it finds a mismatch, and doesn't when there is none. Here you can find a link to our original CRISPR screening video for more information. Let's take a look at the AgroStrow results of the mismatch cleavage assay for each genotype outcome. The homozygous biallelic genotype, the exact one you want, is indistinguishable from wild-type unedited cells. Also note that the heterozygous biallelic genotype is indistinguishable from the monoallelic genotype. This means there's no way to reliably select for the desired biallelic knockout clones. On the plus side, the mismatch cleavage assay is quick and has relatively few parts to assemble. But in terms of screening for desired biallelic knockouts, it is not sufficient. Time for a new approach. Option 3, the in vitro Cas9 cleavage detection assay. As the name suggests, the Cas9 cleavage assay uses the SP-Cas9 endonuclease to screen for gene editing in vitro. First, the gene of interest is PCR amplified. Next, the PCR product is incubated with the SP-Cas9 endonuclease, equipped with a sgRNA that is specific to your gene of interest. Together, this is called a ribonucleoprotein, or RNP. Importantly, this is the same sgRNA that was initially used in the CRISPR knockout experiment. The Cas9 RNP will only bind to the unedited DNA, and thus, it will only cleave if no editing has occurred. Finally, analyzing this result on an agarose gel reveals the precise genotype. 1. A wild-type clone results in two bands. The RNP complex cleaves both alleles. 2. A monoallelic clone results in three bands. The RNP complex cleaves the unedited alleles only. 3. A biallelic clone results in one band, as the RNP complex does not cleave. This assay confidently screens for wild-type, monoallelic, and biallelic edited clones with a simple readout and high accuracy. The Cas9 cleavage detection assay outperforms the mismatch cleavage assay, where monoallelic and biallelic genotypes are indistinguishable, and eliminates the need for costly Sanger sequencing and time-consuming sequence analysis. Let's recap what we've learned so far. With Sanger sequencing, we can obtain accurate sequence-level data. However, it is expensive and time-consuming. The mismatch cleavage assay uses simple gel readout that serves as preliminary screening and reduces the number of clones per sequencing. However, it cannot distinguish between monoallelic versus heterozygous biallelic knockouts and wild-type versus homozygous biallelic knockouts, which can lead to false positive results and false negative results. In comparison, in vitro Cas9 cleavage assay also uses a simple gel readout and can distinguish between four genotypes and serves as a preliminary screening method that reduces the number of sequencing samples. However, this requires additional preparation to synthesize gRNAs, but in return, reduces drastically the downstream time and labor in cell culture work while waiting for sequence verification. Congratulations, you're now a CRISPR knockout expert. Thank you for watching. You can find the screened CRISPR-Cas9 cleavage detection kit, as well as the genomic cleavage detection kit, and SpeedySeq Sanger sequencing services at abmgood.com. Or you can click the links below in the description.